have made my way into the kitchen because it smelled so good in here. Well, I just had to follow my nose. I couldn't wait any longer. And joining us today with a recipe for delicious, juicy maple glazed ham and roasted Brussels sprouts that even your kids are going to love is our very good friend, executive chef of the Peninsula Beverly Hills, our brother, Chef David Codney.
Hello. Hugs all around. It's ham.
Oh, it is ham.
Ham for the holidays.
Ham is the star of the show today. Ken, Kim, and Paigey are ready to dig in for this holiday ham. So, if you would like to forego the turkey
you can call me.
Season, you can call this
because I do to-go food. So if you don't want to cook at home and you don't want to get your kitchen hot and you want to look amazing, call me. Wow. We do to-go.
Are you
serious? Ice cream, champagne, turkeys, done.
He does.
But
you also can do ham.
We also do ham.
That's right. And that's what you're doing today.
That's what we're going to talk about.
By the way, we're going to make your honey glazed ham, which is absolutely delicious. Before we do that, can you please tell everybody how many people you will be serving on Thanksgiving?
I think we're 791-ish.
Oh, my God.
And we have room for you if you want to join.
792?
Call.
All right.
Shameless.
Ham starts with a really great glaze. This is a different glaze.
This is a little bit different glaze because it's got bourbon.
Okay.
Yeah, grandma's secret recipe, right? Okay. Grandma always did the bourbon. So brown sugar. Ooh, right? Very fancy. Right? Some maple syrup. Why
nice.
Maple syrup?
Why not?
Exactly. Yeah. Best maple syrup comes from Cuyahoga County, Ohio. Why, you might ask?
What?
Because I'm from Cuyahoga County.
I was
about to say.
I know.
Cameron isn't here.
Bourbon, right?
Okay.
And then
nice.
A little thing we like to call grandma or grandmonier, right? Which is like a orange cognac, if you will, right?
Yeah, which is interesting because I've heard of the bourbon before, but never the grandmonier.
Yeah, exactly. You can really taste the orange.
You could take the orange makes it nice and effervescent. A little bit of Dijon mustard.
Okay.
Why Dijon?
Why?
Because it's strong. Right? And it's French. Some orange zest, some thyme, right?
Okay.
Some white pepper. Ooh.
Why white pepper,
not black pepper? Because it tastes better.
Does it taste different?
No, there's actually a really long story about quatre d'épices, which means four spices in French. And it's a very Christmassy thing. So it's like nutmeg, white pepper, bunch of other things in there. And it's four, it's white. It goes in boudin blanc, which is a white sausage.
So you don't want to darken it with the
I
pepper.
See.
Makes sense, right?
And did you just put clove in there as well?
I put clove in here and a little bit of cinnamon. And it makes this beautiful, beautiful glaze,
it
right?
It smells like Christmas,
yes,
David.
Yes, it does smell. Mm.
Look
right?
at that, wow.
We're going to take a pan.
Oh
right?
my goodness, that's
Put
beautiful.
This right here. We're going to add a little water to the bottom. Why water to the bottom? Thank you for asking, right? What we're going to do is add, because we don't want the sugar
my
to caramelize,
mouth was
right?
Full. There's nothing. I was going to say that, but my mouth was full.
Okay, so you put the ham inside. Make sure you pull your ham out an hour before you need to cook
Why?
It. Why? Because it has moisture on the outside. You want this glaze to adhere. You want it to get sticky. You want it to look beautiful, right?
I want to put this glaze on ice cream. I want to put this glaze
so
on
good.
Just about anything. It's so delicious.
So
now, before you put this on our ham, there are many hams out there.
Yes. What kind of ham?
What kind of ham do you choose?
Why did you look at me when you said that, buddy? Why did you look at me?
There are plenty of hams out there to be had.
We're going
to
use spiral cut bone-in ham. Why, you might ask? Because it's pre-cut, right?
Okay.
So I like to tell everybody, do you do crown molding at home?
Mm-hmm.
No!
Oh,
do
yeah.
you do crown molding at home?
I do.
Some of us that don't do it every day, right? You do crown molding. Do you invite your whole family over to watch you, you know, do crown molding?
No.
Yes. No! So you get a pre-cut ham. You carve that stuff up in the back. You make your mistakes. You platter. You bring it out. You look
no
like a
No one will
stud.
Ever know.
Nobody
Perfect.
Will know.
I mean, even if a chef is telling you to carve the ham in the back, that's the way to go.
That's it,
even,
man.
Even a chef will mess
yeah,
up.
Yeah, that's it.
It never
Why
looks like Norman Rockwell.
No, it never does. Keep a little bit of glaze on the back, right?
Okay.
You're going to keep that from the side so you can keep glazing it up, right?
Right.
So if there's not enough glaze, it's not crystallized, not crunchy, not good.
Okay.
If you close your eyes and think of like a magazine with a beautiful ham, if it doesn't look like that, add more as you go in, right?
Okay.
Make sense?
Right.
Okay.
So you can cover that up too, cover up the mistakes that way as well, just by adding glaze.
Exactly.
Okay, beautiful.
Okay, perfect. So,
we pop this
put
in.
This in the oven. I like to cook to temperature, so about 165. Remove it then, let it rest, right?
Okay.
We're gonna go over here. Yeah.
Ooh, 165 wow. for how long,
wow.
you said?
I'd say about 2 to 3 hours, depending.
Oh, look,
wow.
at that.
Look at that, right?
Come on.
Amazing.
Wow.
So really low and slow.
Low and slow. And if it gets Great. Too dark, all you do is take your trusty tin foil, right? Pop it over top.
That is
finish
gorgeous.
It, right?
Just tent
Simple
it.
And easy. Tent
I
it.
Okay, now you told us to go in the back and carve this, but I hate to break the news to you. You're on national television in front of people, so you're going to have to carve
but
in front of all of us.
I would, but I'm very nervous.
Oh, okay.
So instead, I'm going to show you how to do Brussels sprouts.
Which, you do Brussels sprouts like nobody's business.
I do
they
Brussels sprouts
like
over
so
dinner.
Good.
They're little
they're
nuggets
so
of goodness.
They're nuggets so of love, right?
Yes.
So my mother, I'm not supposed to say this, but this is between us, right? Little secret. Okay, so my mom used to burn things. She's actually a phenomenal cook, but she would always burn things. She put them on the broiler on the bottom, and the fire alarm would be the timer.
Oh.
So it's going off. We're like, hey, there's something in the bottom down there, right? So anyway, this is an homage to the burn side. She doesn't burn a lot.
Better the fire alarm than the fire department.
Yes, Christy, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Okay, so anyway, we do Brussels sprouts. Why? Because they have this yeasty quality to them, and they're amazing, right? And not everybody cooks them this way. So please don't buy frozen Brussels sprouts.
Okay.
Buy regular ones. Cut them in half. Sear them in a pan. Put them in a nice, beautiful
bowl.
Yeah, just olive oil. Olive oil and salt. That's the secret,
right?
That's it. You take some of this stuff. You want to do this with me?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, a little bit of pomegranate molasses, right?
Oh.
Ooh, wow. Why? Because this is like the Mediterranean.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, so gorgeous.
Some of those. And while you're doing this, I'm going to grab myself some goat cheese.
And just pomegranate seeds, huh?
Pomegranates on top. They're called perils, right? Is that what the word?
Who knows? Non-perils.
Oh, look at you, man. You're so fancy.
Oh, they're so French.
And then we take goat cheese and we put it in the freezer. Why are we putting it in the freezer?
You're
so good at this, right? Because it's hard and you take some microplane.
Okay.
Ooh, right? And we grate it on top.
So if you, it would crumble.
Yeah, so it goes in. Wow.
Oh, that is brilliant.
Yes.
That alone.
Little Christmas on this time right here. Inside snow.
It's definitely going to be a white Christmas.
So speaking of white Christmases, David, I hear you actually usually have one, which is odd for someone who works in Beverly Hills.
Yes, but my kids live in Lake Tahoe area, right? So I like to drive up there. We go in. We put them on the ski slopes. They wear little helmets. They're like cannonball babies, right? You put them on the ski slopes. Yeah, that's them. And it's the best time, right? They all hang out and they have fun because you have to wear out children.
Yes.
Yeah. Right. Otherwise, it's a crazy Christmas.
That's true.
Exactly.
So try.
All right. Sorry, David.
Am I carving
a piece of hand, my friend?
Don't worry. No one's looking. You're by yourself in the back kitchen.
Yeah. Why don't you taste some of that while I do some of this?
Sure.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Yeah. You're going to carve that baby for me because I need to taste that ham.
It is all absolutely gorgeous.
Look at that. Oh, it's hamtastic. Well done, David.
Speaking of hams, I love that. This recipe is part of our Countdown to Christmas digital cookbook, which you can download right now at HallmarkChannel.com.